And this is the second number from Ron Geesin, and this one has the evocative title also of 3/4-inch plywood cover for voice.
There's someone running about through my nose, he cried, which only splintered a few teeth, and nobody heard. A 3/4-inch plywood cover, with a definite coating of polyurethane indestructible varnish, slowly lowered itself, helped by someone, over the sun, which, notwithstanding the plentiful supply of hindrances which it already had to shine through, such as foggy brain layers with moisturized windows and window cleaners with large bottoms, fought on and naturally got redder. Redder? He cried. But tears are very scarce in Western society, so he sold them for great profit, poking the crisp, crunkly notes through his nose to attempt a dislodgity of someone. But he missed the beam entirely, and the crunklies floated off into the azurity beyond, behind, and far away. His very own son glared extremely at life, since if the Cronklies had come anywhere near to it, they would have burst into flames, and the sun would have also conflagrated and severely scorched his 63.5% efficiency brain. Not a bad percentage for a brain that had struggled through the British education system and suffered the odd rupture. The very peculiar rupture. Seeing all this, they, the people, enlightened. What's wrong with not seeing? And almost immediately, little cubicles plopped all around them, and soon had their little walls drilled and decorated and stripped and plugged and painted and varnished and hung with wires and punctured with screws and nails, and had filers and boilers under their little walls, which caused them to scream in silence, since the very vision sets were so loud and bright. Mind you, the only other thing the cubicles had to put up with was an outrageous state of farting.
And farting and very vision sets was the enlightenment of the people, and pick of your nose and dirt of your ears were their favourites.
But this still didn't get rid of someone running about through his nose, and he had to huff and puff and snort and blow, but since someone had already affixed a brand new metal catwalk with new affixatives like expanding flesh screws and red raw plugs, all that came shooting out was bits of thoughts and old ideas and a quantity of 3/4-inch plywood dust. So he stopped there very quickly for fear of losing his 3/4-inch plywood cover and some very expensive nylon trimmings, fittings, accessory strappings and accoutrements. Perhaps you could help him.
Ron Geesin's second LP is long overdue, and there are no reports recently that it's being worked on or completed or anything, which is sad. Anyway, that was the 3/4-inch plywood cover for voice.